Today I want to demonstrate how I get more complex patterns like this. So we start with some curves. I have from the draft workbench a Bezier curve, a wire, and I have a sketch. So, and the first thing what I want to do is I want to create a starting pattern, an array of this, of the combination of these three kinds of curve. So I select the three objects, and the first function is create an array. In this case, I create an array with three columns and two rows. This is configurable, but I start with this one. So I hide my starting objects, and now I have to calculate all the cut points of the curves. This is the next step. I call it split edges, and I get this result. And now I can do some modifications. So I can select here some curves and can remove these edges. So I get this result, and I can repeat this step. Say here I select some curves, here I select this, and so on. And this way here I have to delete this too. Okay, so now I have different patterns inside of this array, and the next step now is create a single pattern. And we see all the areas are detected and filled with different colors. All these objects are separate parts, so I can hide some of them to look through this way. Okay, and I can also do this with more complex object. So now I have two sketches, the Bezier curve and the wire, all three objects. I select them, workflow, create an array, hide the starting object. So I really can combine different objects. From here I split the edges. Takes a little bit longer in this case. Now I can subtract again some edges. And I skip this and I create a single pattern. There are a lot of sub areas here. Each area gets another color, is another part. So I have this, and I also can create larger patterns the same way. The size, I think, will be configurable in future too. And we can see now how the pattern grows. And what we see here is we have a layout which is sometimes overlapping. I can change this by modifying the sketches. Okay, that's it.